I say again, God is set to do something unique in somebody's life. In this service, you are changing level. We are going to lift up our voice one more time and say, Father, for the good work you have started in my life, in this 21-day prayer and fasting, I return glory unto you. Lift up your voice and thank God from the depth of your heart. You have started something new. You have started something unique. You have started something awesome. What no man can give to me, your hand is already stretched out to give it to me. The door which no man can open for me, you are already opening the door. Lord, I return glory. I return glory. I return glory to you. I return glory to you, Lord. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. This year, what stops others will not be able to stop you. Amen. Where others go and fail, when you go, you will get results. Amen. Anyone looking for you on the floor, they will discover you have changed position to the top. Anyone looking for you in the pit, they will be surprised. God has taken you to your top. Anyone waiting for your bad news, only good news will they be hearing from you. Whoever is waiting for your shame, let the God of Oyedepo disappoint them. Whoever is waiting for your disgrace, let the God of Oyedepo disappoint them. Any man or woman that will be involved to plan your shame, to plan your going down, I decree, let these 21 days be their day of vengeance. Let these 21 days be their day of vengeance. Let the 21 days of prayer and fasting be their days of vengeance. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Programmers of evil on assignment against your life, I decree, let their altar backfire against them. In the name of Jesus Christ. 2018, you will not be on the same spot. Every day, every week, every month, you will be changing levels. Your helpers will not miss road. Your helpers will locate you. If you are saying amen, say better amen. So shall it be. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. It is my new dawn era. What eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, shall be the order of the day in my life. It says to all, congratulations and amen. Put your hands together for Jesus and please be seated. Praise God. Maximizing the blessedness of prayer and fasting, part 2. And in this service, we're going to be seeing how fasting can give us access to our high places in life. Fasting is not an opinion that you will debate. Fasting is a commandment that you must subscribe to. Fasting is not a choice you will reject. It is something that your life needs to experience the fullness of God's plan and purpose for your life. I remember the testimony of Dr. Paul Enenche. He said he was on a flight. He noticed that the man was muttering words. So he now asked him, what was he doing? He said that he was in a fast. So he now asked him, which church? He said, which? No church. But they are in the other camp. But before the man will know what is happening, he said that they are fasting to create some evil that will take place in America. So he allowed the man to offload first. By the time the man finished offloading, he burst into tongues. The man kept quiet forever till the plane landed. In the first service, I remember Zach Pomo, if you have seen his book. Zach Pomo, yeah. Now, in that his book, he said some Satanists organized a fast to release spirits so that the level of divorce, immorality, churches will come under massive and severe attack. So after the fast, some churches that we are not used to prayer, you know, there are churches that they hate prayer. Yes, now they say the prayer thing is too much. Yeah. We have not even started prayer. Some people are already complaining. Monday prayer, Friday prayer, Saturday morning prayer. I don't get something to do. Pastor, get something to do. Amos, I don't have anything to do. Mike, I don't have anything to do. Every day, prayer, 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 prayer. Prayer Thursday, prayer Tuesday. Man, I see prayer chop. So after the fasting, it was a massive attack on the churches in Johannesburg, in Pretoria, in Soweto, in Port Elizabeth, in Sun City. Divorce was on the peak. Pastors, we are being hit by marine spirits, the suppliers of fornication. And that's how marriages were scattering, churches were all manner of evil. Now, I remember what he said in that book. He said, if they could be fasting to do evil and they were being answered by their evil powers, he said, how much more you when you fast, when you pray? Do like this. My belly. You know, go kill me. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Food can kill you. What fasting does is to enlarge your capacity to take delivery of the blessings that God has prepared for you. Every time we make up our mind to go into a God-ordained fast, we shut down satanic servers, satanic mirrors, satanic altars, bands of wickedness are destroyed. Can you now see why you are going through manipulation? Anytime they call for fasting, that's when you are angry the most. Forces are making sure that you don't do this thing and you don't do it well. 3 days is enough. Some will say 3 days is enough. Hear me? There are doors that will never open for you until you fast with the whole of your heart. There are heights you will never reach until you do this fasting beyond what you are used to. Scripture says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has he entered into the heart of man what God has prepared for them that love him. Do you love God? I want you to hear this. What people have not seen take place in your life before, it will show this year. Amen. If you are saying amen, say it better, amen.
Amen.
So this fasting is ordained of God to move you to your next phase, to your next place, to your next level of supply, to your next level of blessing. Scripture says, seek ye the Lord now that he may be found. Call upon him now that he can hear you. Seek him now that he will be found. They that seek me early shall do what? They that seek me early. Before you start any venture, seek God. Before you enter any relationship, seek God. Before you enter any venture, seek God. Seek God. Before you begin a new year, seek God. I will go before thee, and I will make the crooked places straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass. I will cut in sunder the bars of iron. The reason why we are waiting on the Lord is so that he can go ahead of us. People say, the one I did on the first is enough. Where you are going is far for the one on the first to carry you alone. We are going to read that scripture again, Amos chapter 5 from verse 4. For thou saith the Lord unto the house of Israel, seek ye me, and ye shall what? Condition. If you don't seek me, you will leave. Seek ye me and leave. The more you seek him, the more better you live. The more you seek him, the more glorious your life becomes. Seeking God is not a choice, it's a must. It's not a choice, it's what? A must. Now look at verse 5. This one concerns you very well. But seek not better, nor enter into Gilgal, and pass not to Beersheba, for Gilgal shall surely go into captivity, and Bethel shall come to naught. Does that mean that Gilgal is bad? No. Does that mean that Bethel is bad? Bethel was a place of an encounter. Gilgal was also a place of an encounter. You have encountered God before. That does not mean that that's the bus stop. The fact that you encountered God 3 years ago, 4 years ago, does not mean that you have arrived. No. You just started your journey. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Huh? One young man said that his pastor no get word. If you see word, you go bow. Well, it's not your fault. If you have word, I'm sure you should have been pastoring a church. Am I saying the truth? This pastor no pray reach me now. Would they pray if we need her like this? If truly you can pray, I'm sure by now you own a deliverance ministry. Yeah, you just be praying and prophesying for the people. Those are people that were in Gilgal before. Hear me? God wants to advance your life. Scripture said the path of the just is like a shining light that shines brighter and brighter. If it must shine brighter, you will seek him farther. If your life will shine brighter, you will seek him farther. My soul longeth for thee, my flesh thirsted after thee to see thy power. You don't seek him once to see thy power. Every time we seek God, things change around us. So fasting gives us that platform that as we seek him in fasting and prayer, he unfolds his plan and purpose for our life. The heavens, I hope you know the opening of the heavens changes. If you experienced open heaven last year, the heavens wants to open wider for you this year. You see, someone is not saying amen. If you experienced breakthrough last year, God wants to give you a bigger breakthrough this year. If you made progress last year, God wants to give you progress that is bigger than that progress. If you succeeded last year, God wants to give you what we call surpassing success. If you are not saying amen, say better amen. But he said, seek me and live. Seek me and live. But in Jeremiah chapter 29 and verse 13, and ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall search for me with all. With what? With all your heart. Don't do a fasting that the whole of your heart is not involved. Whether you like, call it partial fast, I don't know what makes it partial. There is no fast that is partial. It is either you are fasting or you are doing dieting. It's either you are fasting or you are on hunger strike. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Some people don't know that they need to fast for academic success. Let me share with you a testimony. Dr. Luko has shared this testimony of a young man that every time they were calling for prayer, he was always getting angry. Now, he traveled abroad for his PhD. So, when he has finished his coursework, it was to do his defense. The day before his defense, he had a dream of an attack that came. He ignored that dream, but guess what? When he entered into the conference room to meet the profs that were to interview him or ask him questions, he was like a dummy. He couldn't answer anything. His head turned toward there. So they were now wondering, was he the one that actually wrote the something? They will ask him, are you sure you are the one that wrote it? How come you can't say anything now? He felt confused. Immediately he came out. Because then Dr. Luko Yatu was doing his PhD over there. Immediately he came out. He now ran to go and meet him. He said, sir, I think it's time to pray. It's time to do what? You may pretend you don't need prayer and fasting now, but you will need it tomorrow. So you now say, it's time to pray. Look at your laugh. Which prayer? He said, that thing that you talked about, that dream, the thing has come again. So you now ask him, what now happened? He said, will you believe that I appeared before those professors? I couldn't say anything. But a night before that day, I saw that dream. Hear me? On Tuesday, we are going to deal with powers that causes failure at the verge of breakthrough. Now, they attacked him in the dream. He just ignored it. So he felt it was academic work. Do you know that they can suspend your brain? Who has seen blackout in exam before? I want to say something. Raise your hand. In my third year, I did a course called Advanced Physics, stroke geophysics. We have solved every question that we needed to go through. Because the question doesn't have plenty writing. It's only calculate. As we entered the exam hall, it didn't reach 5 minutes, blackout. Me talking. I sat down for over 1 hour, 30 minutes. I couldn't write anything. My friends that were around told me, "What's happening?" I said, "I'm coming. Right now, I'm coming." All of a sudden, Lakoshito pare zesusiri atola. I plead the blood of Jesus. It was not hunger that was doing me. Because some people write exam with hunger. My own was not hunger. It was an attack from the pit of hell. All of a sudden, it's like there was a sweep. The whole thing came back. In less than 16 minutes, I was able to write 2.5 questions, and I had B. So when the result came out, I went to meet the man. I said, "I want to see what I wrote. I want to know how I got B." At first, he was angry. I said, "No, sir, I'm not asking for a market. I just want to see." Then I knew that there were forces that can attack him before exam. Should I say this? Any power waiting for your failure, they will be disappointed. That's why you need to embrace this fast. There are forces that want you to fail in the office. Yes, so. There are forces that want you to fail. But every time you give yourself to an ordained fast, God goes ahead of you. Disappoint their counsel. Scripture says, "He frustrated the token of liars and make diviners to be mad." Do you want to fail? That's why you must seek your helper. "Lord, in this assignment, I will not be a failure. The plan of the wicked will not come to pass in my life." As part of my prayer this year, anyone on assignment against my assignment, "Lord, baptize them with vengeance." I'm praying it. And it must catch somebody. Oh, I know. I'm praying it and it must catch somebody. I know. So if you are on assignment against my, I am sent here to represent the mandate. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The Liberation Commission. If you are sent here on assignment against my assignment, I promise you, vengeance must catch you. Amen. Oh, you don't know? That's why you need to fast. So that any force, human, when God needed to reach the earth, he needed a man. When Satan wants to walk his havoc, he will also use a man. It will come like breeze. Spirits don't have power over here. So they will need a man. This is our domain. Oh, you don't know? That's why Jesus couldn't come as a spirit. He had to come as a son of man. And knowing fully well that this is my domain, you go die quick. So any force, you destabilize forces every time you engage in a fast. You heard that testimony about what happened in Johannesburg? If Satanists could fast, why can't you fast? they could release forces to scatter something. You too, you can release forces that will bring something. Do you want to watch the plan of God for your life be manipulated by human forces? Do you know what is moving them? Do you know what is controlling them? That's why you need to fast. You need to give yourself to God ordained fast. So that your life, your family, your career will experience the hand of God. And when you have now made up your mind to fast, look at how the enemy is now making you look as if you don't know what you are doing. Hunger that don't used to catch you before. Watch out. After this fasting now, all that hunger that you thought was catching you will not catch you again. It's amazing, no? It is amazing. Now, fasting have come. 9 o'clock, it look as if you have not eaten for 2 days. 9 o'clock. Am I saying something to somebody? That goes to let you know that there is power behind food. There is power behind food. There is power behind food. Esau sold his birthright. Because of what? He said, take this food and give me the porridge. What is birthright? There's nothing in birthright. But after he sold it, he complained. You have supplanted me these 2 times. You collected my... Oh, so you now know the meaning of birthright. Are you seeing it now? He said, you have supplanted me this 2nd time. The 1st time, you collected my birthright. Now you have collected the blessing ahead of me. But he was the one that said with his mouth, there is nothing in this birthright. Give me food. There is nothing in birthright. Too. Just collect this thing and give me food, Jared. Can you now see? Anytime food wants to make you break your fast, you want to abort your heritage. You want to abort it. What is heritage? Have I not been living before? You can't live well until fasting takes place. I like the way Pastor Biomi said, he said, fasting helps to fast forward our destiny. Our destiny gets fast forwarded. Scripture said, I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the canker worm and the plummer worm. I will restore. So every time we engage in a fast, 5 years delay, 10 years delay, 15 years setback is fast forwarded. No wonder after fasting, you will just be experiencing open doors. Helpers that have not shown their face before, you now be asking, where have all these people been hiding? What unlocks them is the fasting. It's the fasting. For you to gain access to great heights, let's read this scripture before we go on. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 14. Then shall thou delight thyself in the Lord, and I will cause thee to ride upon the high places of the earth, and feed thee with the heritage of Jacob, thy father, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. Who seeth it in and it cometh to pass, when the Lord commanded it not? By myself have I sworn, God swore hell, in blessing I will bless you, in multiplying I will multiply you. But God is saying, I'm taking you to your high places. High places means meeting high people. You can't go to a high place by meeting low people. You go to a high place by meeting high people. Pastor, am I correct? The quality of people you meet determine the kind of places you enter. Yes, you don't enter great places by meeting non-entities. Which means there will be a shift. Say with me, a shift in your connections. God now begin to connect you with people that matters. People that will help change your levels. Financial change of level. Career change of level. Abba, there are people you must meet. And those people can only be assessed in the realm of the spirit through fasting. Where God now begins to stamp your name in their hearts. Where through dreams and vision they begin to see your name. How did the Ethiopian Enoch connected to his baptism? He desired the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And God appeared to who? God appeared to Philip. He said, get down to Joppa. There is somebody you need to meet there. He desired the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And I'm sending you to make sure that this thing becomes a reality. In your fast, there are people that must hear your name. There are people God must move. They are not the one moving themselves. God is the one moving them. To meet you. When they meet you, they open your door. Is Saul also among the prophets? As he came into the midst of the prophets, he went to his high place. There are people you just meet, man. High jump. You scale heights. You scale heights. My driver was asking me yesterday that if he goes by NI, he will just be looking like Mumu. I said, get ready. Next month, I will get your passport ready. He will travel with me. He started saying, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. He said, since they bombed me, I never travel by air. I say, okay, you will travel now. Change of level. I said, get ready. Immediately we'll finish our fasting. I'll give you money. I'll tell you who to meet. They'll prepare your passport immediately. Hear me? Any devil blocking your access from meeting the people that will lift you, that satanic barrier will be swallowed up! And you know, let me say this, somebody must hear it. The kind of people you meet will determine whether you will suffer slow motion or whether you will gain speed. I'm the one telling you. Check the people around you now. Are they helping you to go forward? Which means you need higher people. You need higher people. But before God will connect you, take you to your high place, I, the Lord, search the heart. Your heart determines your height. I, the Lord, search the heart. That's why the heart of man is the engine room of his destiny. It is a mystery. When your heart is after God, good begin to go after you. No wonder scripture says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me. When your heart is after God, good begin to follow you. When your heart is after the goodwill of the house of God, God begin to release good men of goodwill after you. People that will whine you, drive you to your high place. What is in your heart? No wonder in this fasting, God is saying, my son, give me your heart. Not your cash. God is not looking for what to collect from us. He wants to change our heart because of where next he wants to take us to. The heart is a mystery. I, the Lord, search the heart. To reward every man according to his deed. To strengthen those whose hearts are perfect towards me. So God must confirm your heart. This person, is he really following me? There are some people that follow you because of what they want to collect from you, not because they like you. Are you what I'm saying now? That's why they can still collect the thing from you and still be abusing you. They can still collect the thing from you and be speaking against you. Their heart is heart answered to heart. And if truly you are following God and someone is just collecting something from you and is working against you, it doesn't take time. They will be exposed. I, the Lord, searched their heart. It does not look face. Samuel was sent to go and sort out a king from the house of Jesse. They were coming one by one. He said, oh, look at this one. He looks so robust. He looks so macho. God said, man, Samuel, leave that thing where you see. Oh. Me in the heart now, they check. Oh. All these people, where you don't they see? I know they with these people. One, two. Eliab pass. Jonadab pass. He said, no. He said, is there still another one? He said, yes, there's another one. But that one is in the bush. So people with the bush, they need to present them. He said, please bring that one. Let's see whether they want. I will wait. Let's know whether that's the one the Lord is looking for. When David appeared, God just spoke. That's the one. Pour the oil in. That's the man after my heart. Forget all these other people. I, the Lord, searched the heart. When your heart is after God, change of position is not a struggle. You may be in the bush. You may be in a place where no one knows you. But let your heart be after God. The throne is calling for you. Great places begin to look for you. When your heart is after God, you can't miss your right place. When your heart is after God, you can't miss your right place. My soul longed for thee. My flesh thirsted after thee. When your heart is after God, you can't miss your right place. As a child of God, I want you to hear this. You have a heritage of succeeding success. You succeeded. Now God wants you to succeed again. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? What is success? Success simply means succeeding in succession. That's the meaning of success. Succeeding in succession. What does it mean to succeed in succession? You succeeded last year. But this year, God is saying the result you will get will be bigger than the one you got last year. That is what it means to succeed in succession. Succeeding in succession. But that cannot be in place without your heart being after God. What makes for success? Is it because you are skillful? The race is not to the swift. Not that your battle to the strong. Not your favor to men of skill. It's a time and chance happening to them all. I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy. And I will also show compassion on whom I will show compassion. What makes for success is the grace of God. What makes for success is the favor of God. What makes for success is the wisdom of God. But it will only answer to those whose hearts are after God. If you are after God, good must be after you. Good must pursue you. He says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you. Whether you like relocate from Abuja and come to Lafia, and you are just looking at the environment, you say, is there anything good for me in this town? Scripture says, goodness and mercy go pursue you. So every height we want to attain is determined by our heart. Every height. Every time you want to increase in height, all you just need to do is to increase your depth of passion towards God. Your love towards God. Many of you that I'm seeing here now, you don't belong to any unit. Second service is not your unit. You ask someone, which unit do you belong? Second service. Is second service a unit? As I'm talking now, there are people inside here that can sing more than people that are taking praise worship. I'm the one telling you. They said, no, I don't want them to know me. Die with your gift. Scripture said, the gift of a man maketh way for him. and bringeth him before princes and kings. You want to lock your own and suffer. After today, Helen, stand up. As I finish this message, y'all pass like this. Come and see this person. I'm talking to somebody now as I'm talking. The Holy Ghost is hitting someone. You want to cage the gift? Your blessing may be caged. It's a danger. God didn't give you the gift for fun. He said, these people have I formed for my glory, that they will show forth my praise. He has given you this grace, and now you are locking it up. As you are singing his praise, he's also announcing you. But locking it up is a sign that your heart is not after God. Your heart is not after God. David said, my heart and my affection is set towards the house of my God. Where is your heart? Because where your heart is today will determine where God will place you this year. So increasing your passion for God. Hear me? Let me say this. What has fasting got to do with my heart? Fasting tears down the walls of carnality. Carnality is an enmity of spirituality. The more carnal you are, the quicker your passion for God dies. Carnality kills our passion for God. But spirituality stirs up our hunger. A day I spend in your courts is more than 1,000 years outside. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tent of wickedness. Where is your heart? Where your heart is will determine where God will place you. So if you want to become outstanding in your career, if you want to experience a change of position, then you must determine to follow God, to pursue God, to seek God. Even as we are doing in this fasting, what fasting does is to help you so that you can seek Him better. Seek Him better. So in fasting, we are taking roots downwards. We are taking roots downwards so that we can bear fruit upwards. If you don't take roots, you can't bear fruit. So your passion and your love for God is what determines the mark you will make on the earth. So in fasting, let's look at verse 6, Psalm 50, Isaiah 58, and verse 6. Verse 6. Is it not the fast I have chosen? To loose the bands of wickedness, to undo the heavy burdens, and to let the oppressed go free, that ye break every yoke. That ye break every yoke. You are loose from the bands. Bands of distraction. Bands of evil association. There are some friends that are not helping you to grow spiritually. In fact, since you became a friend to that person, your spirituality died. Your carnality went on fire. Yes? You loved prayer before. All of a sudden, prayer is like poison to you now. Why? You need to be loosed from that band of evil tie. I like the way Dr. Paul Enenche puts it. There are people you must miss if you must not miss God. There are people you must do what? Missing God is more terrible. Why? Those people may not be there for you all the time. I hope you know, when events change, friendship change. That's why you need God that cannot change. He's there with you in the rain. He's there with you in the sun. He's there with you when everything is working. Any friend that is not adding to your spirituality is a winch sent against you. When I say this thing, people just laugh. Any person that is not adding value to you, that is increasing carnality in you, is a winch. I said so. Go call police for me. Am I correct? Any person that is not motivating you, driving you to the things of God, man, run for your life. How do you lick orange? You suck. You are sucking. That's how they will suck you. They suck you, suck you, suck you. By the time they have sucked you everything, they all drop you quietly. When you finish lick orange, you put it in your pocket. No. That's how they will suck you, suck you. By the time they finish sucking you, they all drop you quietly and they look for another one. Now so. Hear me and hear me well. You need to be loose from that band of wickedness. If not, you can't develop. You don't just suddenly develop hunger for God. There must be an atmosphere. There must be an environment. There must be a relationship. There must be a connectivity. Check out anyone that made a mark. They experienced a change of level. Their love for God was exceptional. Joseph stood out because of his love for God. How can I do this thing and sin against God? With all the wickedness that he suffered, household wickedness, thrown into the pit, locked in the prison, troubled by Potiphar's wife, but yet he didn't miss it. You will not miss it. Amen. If you are saying amen, say better amen.
Amen.
That's why you must rededicate your heart back to God. You must renew your love back to God. They were going to Gilgal to renew the covenant, but hear me, this is our modern day Giga. Why? We want to go higher. Every time there is a hunger in you to go higher, you stir up the hunger and God begins to move you forward. You begin to come afresh, longing for something new in your fellowship with God. You know, fellowship is in levels. In the word, in prayer. If you have been praying 5 minutes in the spirit, God is saying, it's time to go 10 minutes. If you have not even been studying the word before, do you know that some people only open their Bible? Funny enough that we have technology now. They don't even come with Bible. When you say, open your Bible, they all pray your phone. Genesis chapter 10. And the same phone is watching WhatsApp and Facebook every day. It can never open his Bible 5 minutes. If I'm lying, say I'm lying. Do you know some people can be on Facebook for 1 hour? Too small. Good. Now, can you see something? You have something that has the potential of catching your attention. Switch that potential now. Switch it over to the word. Now we are doing 21 days fasting. I bet you there are some people that can watch Facebook more than reading the Bible. And you are shouting, it's my new dawn. How will it dawn? It can never dawn. Eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. If eyes must see it, God must reveal it. And if God must reveal it, you must pray. You shall seek me and find me when you shall search for me with the whole of your heart. The word must be revealed to you. Some people in here, their pastors are in Facebook. That is telling them that tithe is nonsense. It's old covenant. Go and open church. Let the man open church so that you can become his member. Poverty go hit on our family. And those people preaching such things, they are begging people. Write it down, I said so. They beg this one. They don't have open heaven. They are looking for people that will believe the evil they are saying. Why? The people that believe in it are the people that are not doing it. Yes, you are correct. Tithe is in the Old Testament. Because they are not practicing it. Apostle Suleiman said, tell that the frenzy, I've increased my tithe to 30%. It should go to hell. Don't you know that through fasting, God opens the door of supply? Oh, you don't know? It's in the book of Ezra. He said, we will seek the Lord for our substance and for our children. Where is your heart? Scripture says, where a man's heart is, there is where his treasures are. Where are your treasures? If your treasures are in God, you will seek God. You will seek the goodwill of God. You will seek the plan and purpose of God. What I want to say to one, everyone here now, you are overdue for a change. That amen is weak. I say again, you are overdue for a change. I say again, you are overdue for a change. No wonder God said, you have long encompassed this mountain long enough. It's a turn. Turning means change. Change your heart. Begin to seek God. Renew your love for God. Let your rededication. Oh, Paul said, did you start in the spirit to end up in the flesh? There were some people that were burning for zeal. Burning with zeal 4 years ago, 3 years ago. Now they have become matured Christians. They are now Jesus' auntie. They are now Jesus' uncle. Prayer is now a problem to them. When they see people praying, people have not started. We are the ones that started Lafayette Church. Should I say something? You are old school. You are in Romans. You are not in Corinthians. I like you to come back. Where you drop God, that's where he drops you. The Lord is with you while you are with him. If you forsake him, he will delete your number. He will delete your number. You won't even see text message. Rise up to your feet. David prayed a prayer. He said, may the Lord send you help out of Zion. And strengthen you out of his sanctuary. You are going to pray, Lord, I renew my heart to follow you. Whatever has taken my heart. I just heard something now. Somebody here, you will break that relationship today. That relationship that took you away from God. I don't know you, but the Holy Ghost knows you. I don't know even why this one is coming now. Whoever is the person, you will break that relationship today. You have become more, your carnality is more than an unbeliever. But God is saying, I want to change your story. And the time is now. I want you to pray. Lord, whatever will make me miss my next place, my change of story, deliver me. Whatever has taken my heart away from you, restore me. David said, create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me. Lift up your voice and begin to pray right now. I rededicate my heart to serve you, to follow you. Lord, fuel my heart with passion. Concerning Jesus, scripture said, the zeal of his father's house has consumed me. Lord, renew my passion. I don't want to miss my next level. I don't want to miss my change of level. I don't want to miss my high place. You have prepared a place. David said, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Lord, deliver me from everything that will make me miss my high place. Deliver me from anything that will make me miss my appointed place. Pray from the depth of your heart. God wants to change your level. God wants to move you to your next place this year. You must change level. Pray from the depth of your heart. I rededicate my heart. I rededicate my heart. Whatever want to make me miss my next level. Whatever want to make me miss my appointed place. Holy Ghost, help me in this fasting. Every form of carnality that has overtaken my heart, Lord, by your fire, let the walls of carnality be destroyed. Leon de Kusheko Zaba, Reja Kato Sese, your fan is in your hand. Your fan is in your hand, and you will thoroughly purge our floor. Jekota pari dano sete le canto raba baba baba yaga doze zuzezia legede ruja goda braba bebredo le kate brekle du sazone do lata jekosizi lendere do zikatalia prelia leta razo zepleria rejo zaga dagata. Any force, any manipulation, any programming of the wicked that does not want me to go far, that does not want me to serve God in full, Lord, by your fire, destroy the bands of the wicked. Destroy the control of the wicked. Every siege of wickedness. Lift up your voice and pray. Rando nandolobo shekuzata ilapore dunasetata elako tendi alo shababa rezazake kotre ilaprekotatu shekuteria delata. Pray, pray from the depth of your heart. Your story must change this year. I refuse to be on the same spot. I refuse to be on the same spot. My story must change. Lord, whatever has laid siege over my heart that does not want me to serve God well, Holy Ghost, by your fire, burn off the chaff. Burn off the chaff. Burn off the chaff. Destroy the satanic control. Zekuka, Reantela, Jacusendi Aleta, Recote Predise, Jacote Predigaga, Laborodo Dodo Dodo, Laborodo Dodo Dodo Dodo. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. It is anti-covenant. It is anti-God that you are increasing in service and you are reducing in quality. God forbid batting. How can I be increasing in serving God and my mockery is increasing? My hardship is increasing. It's a lie. My covenant will I not break nor alter. The words that have gone out of my mouth. You say, by myself have I sworn, in blessing, I will bless you. But look at it. God told Moses, tell Pharaoh, let Israel go, that they may serve me. Pharaoh said, I will let Israel go, but
but I don't want them to go too far. You will go far.
Amen.
This year, you will go far.
Amen.
This year, you will go higher.
Amen.
You will not go lower.
Amen.
Financially, you will not go lower.
Amen.
Materially, you will not go lower.
Amen.
Career-wise, you will not go lower.
Amen.
Pharaoh now came again. He said, I will let Israel go, but they will not go with their substance. Meaning, you will serve God in poverty. I will not allow them to go with their sheep and their cattle. They will not go with their... No, go, but don't go with your substance. God punish devil. This year, you will serve God with a blessing.
Yes,
but you are going to pray, Lord, I will serve you with the whole of my heart. My soul will go after you. My soul will go after the kingdom. Lift up your voice and pray. Lord, I will serve you full let. Lekondi haroshia. I will not reduce the quality of my service. Lekate sesi ekutete. Jeklo andopre etuladi. Jekukaria ezana tupo. Jekote belado shonodo. Rekuzizi nagerata. Pei letoria. Lanze garo shagoda. Ero bedu satataliata. Jekle perade di gada gada gada. I will serve you with the whole of my heart. I will serve you. Holy Spirit, help me. I will not reduce the quality of my service. I will not reduce my commitments. I will not reduce my passion. I will not reduce my affection. I will not reduce my hunger. I will not reduce my commitments. Lord, I give my heart to serve you. I give my heart to serve you. I give my heart to follow you. I give my heart to serve you. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. All eyes closed, all heads bowed. Somebody wants to rededicate his life back to God. We are not talking of New Year resolution. We are talking of kingdom commitment. You want to rededicate your life back to God. You want to accept Jesus for a change of position, for a change of level. Jesus can enter into your life and your life remain the same. Wherever you are, inside and outside, you're under the sound of my voice, place your right hand on your chest and pray this prayer after me. If you are the one I'm talking to, say after me, Lord Jesus, I come unto you today. I know that I'm a sinner. Forgive me. I rededicate my heart back unto you. Come into my heart. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. In Jesus' name, I pray. If you pray that prayer with me, wherever you are, inside and outside, carry your bag and your Bible and come right now. Put those hands together for Jesus. You pray that prayer with me. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Come. Put your hands together for Jesus. If you are coming, come quickly. You don't need to be ashamed. This is the best decision anybody can make. This is the best decision anybody can make. Only God can move anybody forward. Only God can move anybody forward. You are not making that decision for anybody. You are making it because you love your life. Lord Jesus, unto them that come unto you, shall you in no wise cast out. They've accepted Jesus Christ, rededicating their life back to God. Unto them that come unto you, shall you in no wise cast out. I pray for them today, as this oil come upon you, every guilt, every accusation of the wicked over your life, they are blotted out in the name of Jesus Christ. Beginning from today, your change of story, your change of position starts in the name of Jesus. If you are saying amen, say better amen.
Amen.
Whatever power kept you on the same spot, That yoke is destroyed in the name of Jesus. Whatever has been hindering you from entering into the blessings that God has ordained for you, today mark the end of that manipulation in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Put your hands together for Jesus for them. Just turn and follow this man right now.
In my life, tormented in my life, Lord.
Lift up your hand as I pray for you. This year, you will scale new heights. Yeah. The doors that didn't open for others will open for you. Yeah. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Yeah. Powers that limit people will not be able to stop you in the name of Jesus. Yeah. I pray for you by the four winds of the Spirit. Be connected to people that matters. Everyone God has ordained to make new dawn a reality in your life, they will not rest until you are located. By dreams and visions, let God stamp your name in their hearts in the name of Jesus. Powers that manipulate failure, whatever they have programmed for you, let the arrow backfire in the name of Jesus. Any power that pulls people down, I decree, wherever they have programmed to pull you down, let their trap backfire. Whoever is programming you to fall, let them fall your fall. Whoever is programming you to die, let them die your death. Any embargo place over you and your family, I pray in the name of Jesus, let the veil scatter. 2018, your family will experience rest. Your family will change levels. In your business, you will change level. In your career, you will change level. Doors will open for you in good new places. Before God takes you high, He connects you to high people. Any high person that is needed for you to experience a change in position, I decree connectivity. Whether they are in Lagos or Abuja or Port Harcourt or in Jos, wherever they are located, north, south, east, and west, London, UK, Germany, Japan, South Korea, wherever they are, be connected by the power of God. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we pray. Any household wickedness that wants to pull you down this year, fire swallow their altar. Anyone planning to shoot you arrow because you want to build house this year, I decree, let them die before the house will start. Say amen like a believer. Anyone that is angry that you are buying a car, and so they want to kill you, let the arrow of death sweep their house. I pray for you. This year, you will not see shame. The God of Oyerepo shield you from every plan of hell. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Your name will not answer in any coven. Your name will not answer before any evil altar. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Wave your hands unto God and give Him praise. Thank Him from the depth of your heart. Lord, I'm giving you all the glory. I'm giving you all the praise. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. Put those hands together for the Lord and please be seated. Praise God.